Do you start something only to give up midway? Or do you get easily frustrated that you are not able to make sustainable lifestyle changes? Then in this session, I will be covering that and more, right? If you're not able to live the life that you want, then maybe it's time to make some changes, right? And that's what I'm going to cover today. I'm going to take you through the five stages of change that all of us go through, and irrespective of what problems that we have or what, you know, of whatever that is we're trying to change in our lives, right? All of us go through these five stages, and that's something that I'm going to cover today, because that might help you to understand the challenges that you are facing and probably can help you to become unstuck. But before that, if you like what I have to say, make sure that you check out the workshop that I have coming up. It's an online workshop on the 5th of December, which is a Saturday at 3 p.m. It will be about 75 minutes or so. There is an accompanying workbook along with this workshop, and you can check out the details at the link anindita.com/change. So I recommend that you check it out, right? Because that will help you to implement what you learn in this session. And this whole month, I will be focusing on this topic. Because as we come to the end of this year, it's a good place to understand how change works, how transformation works, and how we can, make 2021 a year where we can flow with the changes that come up. We can become more intentional about the changes that we want to make in our lives. And at the same time, also become more resilient about changes that are thrust upon us, like it was this year. But today is all about changing your mind and changing your life, right? Because it all starts with your thoughts. It all starts by becoming aware of your inner beliefs, because sometimes that hold us back. And it can be thoughts like, I am not good enough, I am not worthy of making this change or putting in the effort, no one loves me. So there can be many things which is underlying. So it's always a good place to start by asking yourself, what kind of thoughts am I having right now, which is not allowing me to make the changes that I want to make in my life, right? So just by asking yourself that question, you may not get the answer immediately, but that sort of helps you to get started. That sort of helps you to think about where you might be struggling today, right? So what sort of thoughts are you having which is not allowing you to make the changes in your life? So that's always a good place to start. The second thing that I wanted to sort of point out is that the reason that people fail to make changes is often because they are not ready, right? But how do you know that if you're ready or not? So that's where the five stages of change come in. And the five stages are pre-contemplation, contemplation, preparation, action, and maintenance, right? There is a whole book on that. So if you would like to know more about this, you can check out Changing for Good. That's the book. So depending on which stage of change you are in, you can sort of match your preparation according to that. Because when we talk about, for example, the stage of pre-contemplation, that's a stage where most people are not even aware that they have a problem. So it's like that husband who's dragged by the wife to the therapist, and the husband is in complete denial that he has a problem, right? So he keeps pointing out to the therapist that there's nothing wrong with me, I'm absolutely fine, right? So if someone is in the pre-contemplation stage, and it's very difficult for that person to make any sort of change, right? Maybe it's there are ways to bring that person along, but it's quite tough, honestly. The second stage, which is the contemplation stage, is where the person is finally focusing on the solution and is aware of the problem, actually, right? So they are aware that there seems to be an issue, but they are not sure with it, but they are far from doing something about it usually. So they are finding out about it, they are thinking about it. And what often happens at this stage is that people become chronic contemplators. So they keep thinking and thinking about the problem, they keep finding out more and more about the issue. They keep doing more and more research, but they fail to take any action, right? So they remain stuck at this stage. The third step is the preparation stage. This is the stage where the person is finally preparing to take action. So in terms of thinking, this person might be saying that I am planning to take up a gym membership next week. I am planning to start walking from Monday, right? Exercising from Monday. So finally the person is preparing. So I'm going to buy the pair of shoes too so that I can start playing badminton, you know, so that kind of a situation. So they are finally preparing. It's an important stage because preparation is key to successfully, you know, make changes which are sustainable, right? Jumping from one stage to action may not always help, and that's the reason why sudden diets, etc., can't really be sustained, right? There's not much preparation. The fourth stage is the action stage, where actually the person takes action. So in terms of I am walking, you know, I'm already I'm walking right from today, right? Or say next week, I will start tomorrow, or I've already started, right? It can be, not a very black and white kind of differentiation, but in the action stage, the person is already taking some kind of action, right? So that's where the person is. And the last stage is the maintenance stage, where the person is already doing something and finding ways to sustain that, right? So they're already working on that. So the last 6 months they have been working out, they have been walking, or for the last 3 months they have started doing something. So they've already taken action, and it keeps moving them forward. Now the thing is, and that's something that I wanted to sort of point out, it's very important, most people, in fact up to 90% of the people, will have a relapse or will lapse at some point of these stages, at one or the other point of these stages, and that's completely normal. By what I mean by that is that people will circle back and forth between different stages, right? So they might move from one stage to another stage, which is from pre-contemplation to the next one, where they start thinking about the solution to the problem, but they can always again come back to the previous stage. So that's what I mean by circling through the stages of change. And also that's a lapse, right? That's a kind of a relapse that is completely normal. So you need to prepare yourself for that. So what I've taken you through now in the past few minutes is the five stages of change, which is pre-contemplation, contemplation, preparation, action, and maintenance. And I mentioned that if you want to check out, there is a book, a very detailed book on this topic called Changing for Good, right? And I've also mentioned that the reason people fail to make changes is because they are often not ready. And that's the reason, if you know which stage of change you are in, often it helps because you can match the challenges to the stage that you are in right now. And so let me share a story about, you know, a client of mine, because I have a one-on-one health coaching practice where I coach clients on an individual basis. These are women with multiple chronic health issues. And I also have a membership program which I run for women. It's called Peaceful Mind, Healthy Body. And the membership program is actually all about change and ultimately transformation. Transformation is a change that's kind of permanent or long-term. So first, the story about Shweta Shenoy, who came to me for my one-on-one coaching with multiple chronic health issues, including eczema, asthma, etc., allergies. And one of the first things that I have my clients do is change their diet, right? And typically it entails taking off gluten, which includes wheat and some other similar grains. And it includes dairy, which means that giving up milk, dahi, butter, cheese, excluding ghee, everything else basically, and some other foods. But these are the two main foods that most people have a sensitivity towards, their body struggles to digest, and other reasons, I'm not going to get into that. And she was really apprehensive about the changes that I was asking her to make, right? Because I know it's not easy, but through my coaching, through taking her through these changes, moving gently, nudging her along with the help of the coaching process, and we have a very well set out coaching process which helps people find out about their own strengths. There is a way of doing that. It's called character strengths. And then applying their strengths to the different stages, and with the help of my coaching, nudging them gently along through these various stages of change. At the end of the 6 months that she worked with me, she had given up obviously on these foods, but it's not about giving up. It's about making changes in the diet. She was feeling far healthier. Her skin issues had really come down a lot. Her asthma, without medications, etc., her asthma was much under control, and she was really happy with the changes that she was able to make, right? Because again, it's not easy, and she made some other lifestyle changes as well, but she saw the difference. That's the power of making changes when you in a very structured manner. That's where the coaching part comes in. And similarly, in the membership program where I coach a group of women to move towards, it's called Peaceful Mind, Healthy Body, to move towards transformation using a 5-stage journey of transformation process, right? Again, that's where change comes in. Again, we work on building knowing their character strengths, on finding where they are right now, where they need some support and guidance, and then moving along and taking action, right? So preparing to take action, knowing where you are, and then sort of, then you are able to make the changes that you want to see. Then you're able to set the goals that you want for yourself, right? And again, the stages of change may be different for different problems that you have and for the different things that you want to change in your life, right? So this is something that is, that is something that all my clients work towards. And if you would like to, so basically this is what I had to share, right? The 5 stages of change, how your thoughts can help you to either change aspects of your life which may not be working for you, or they can hold you back, right? And if you are ready to start making changes, start finding out where you are at this point in time, figuring out why is it so difficult for you to change, and ultimately set goals the smart way, which includes actually, so then you can sign up for the workshop, which is coming up on the 5th of December. It's called Setting Goals and Making Sustainable Lifestyle Changes. It's on the 5th of December at 3 p.m. And there's a workbook which will accompany that session, so that you can sort of use that not only on that particular day, but even after that, right, to set goals for yourself and to see results. So do sign up at anindita.runta.com/change, anindita.runta.com/change, and I will see you again next week.